Welcome to a time of Bible readings and hymns with your host, David Kenny, of the Wadsworth Church of Christ on West Good Avenue in Wadsworth, Ohio.
When the moonlight glows, we want you back, we want you back. We want the sheep back in the fold. We want you back, we want you back. We want the coin back in its mold. Lost like a sheep that went astray, or a son who dared to roam. Come back to the faith, come back to your God, come back to the fold. We want you back, we want you back. We want the sheep back in the fold. We want you back, we want you back. We want the coin back in its mold. Oh, please don't stay there in the world, for it's temporary joys. Come back to the faith, come back to your God, come back to the fold.
Come back to the fold.
We want you back, we want you back. We want the sheep back in the fold. We want you back, we want you back. We want the coin back in its mold. Though you have wandered far away, you can come back to your home. Come back to the faith, come back to your God, come back to the fold.
The Epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Colossians, the King James Version. Colossians chapter 1. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, and Timotheus our brother, to the saints and faithful brethren in Christ which are at Colossae, grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We give thanks to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you, since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love which ye have to all the saints. For the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof ye heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel, which is come unto you as it is all the world, and bringeth forth fruit as it doth also in you, since the days ye heard of it, and knew the grace of God in truth. As ye also learned Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is for you a faithful minister of Christ, who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you, and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that ye might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. Strengthened with all might, according to his glorious power, unto all patience and long-suffering with joyfulness, giving thanks unto the Father, which hath made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness, and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. For by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself by him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven. And you, that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now have he reconciled, in the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight, if you continue in the faith grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel which ye have heard and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven, wherefore I, Paul, am made a minister. And now rejoice in my sufferings for you, and fill up that which is behind of the afflictions of Christ in my flesh for his body's sake, which is the church, whereof I am made a minister according to the dispensation of God, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God, even the mystery which hath been hid from ages and from generations, and now is made manifest to his saints. To whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory, whom we preach, warning every man and teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. Whereunto I also labor, striving according to his working, which worketh in me mightily.
Manifold wisdom of God.
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 The Lord has made known by his church the wisdom of God. He has made known by the church to all of the worldly powers. He has made known by the church the purpose he's worked through his Son. He has made known through the Spirit his plan from before the ages, and through the church all men shall know the wisdom of God.
Manifold 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 wisdom of God.
The Lord has made known by his church the wisdom of God. He has made known by the church to all of the worldly powers. He has made known by the church the purpose he's worked through his Son. He has made known through the Spirit his plan from before the ages, and through the church all men shall know the wisdom of God.
Bible Readings and Hymns with your host, David R. Kenny, with The Church of Christ in Wadsworth, Ohio. Recorded at WCTV Studios with music provided by Andy Robison. www.churchofchristsongs.com. Bible Readings and Hymns has been produced by the Gospel Broadcasting Network.
When the moon